Hello and welcome back to another episode of Physics Partner. Mirrors are reflective surfaces that bounce light, creating an image of an object placed in front of them. There are two main types of spherical mirrors we commonly encounter: concave mirrors and convex mirrors. Let's explore what makes them unique. A concave mirror is curved inward, like a hollow interior of a sphere or the inside of a spoon. And it's also known as a converging mirror because it brings parallel light rays together at a single point. In contrast, a convex mirror is curved outwards, like the exterior of a sphere or the back of a spoon. It's often called a fisheye mirror or a diverging mirror because it spreads parallel light rays outwards. One key difference lies in their structure. For a concave mirror, the reflective coating is on the outside of the spherical surface and its center of curvature is on the same side as the reflecting surface. However, for a convex mirror, the reflective coating is on the inside of the spherical surface and its center of curvature is located on the opposite side from the reflecting surface. The position of the focus also differs significantly. For a concave mirror, the focus lies in the front of the mirror, meaning its focal length is considered negative. On the other hand, the focus of convex mirror is located behind the mirror, which means its focal length is considered positive. The way these mirrors form images is perhaps the most important distinction. A concave mirror typically forms images that are real, inverted, and enlarged. However, an object is placed very close to a concave mirror, specifically between its pole and its focus, the image form becomes virtual, erect, and still enlarged. A convex mirror, however, consistently forms images that are always virtual, erect, and diminished than the actual object. Due to these image properties, there is a difference in whether the image can be projected. Since concave mirror can form real images, these images can be projected onto a screen. In contrast, because convex mirrors only form virtual images, these images cannot be projected onto a screen. Finally, their everyday uses reflect these unique characteristics. Concave mirrors are used where magnification is needed, such as in shaving mirrors, torch lights, to produce a strong beam. And within reflecting telescopes, convex mirrors are commonly used as side view or rear view mirrors in vehicles because the outward curve provides a much wider area of view, which is crucial for safety on the road.
So I think it's enough for today. So thank you very much for listening and watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope this video is useful for you. So take care of yourself and don't hesitate to write an email if you have any question, query, suggestion, and even classes are required. Take care of yourself meanwhile. See you in the next video. Goodbye.